Praise the Lord, everyone. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. I want to thank each of you for joining with me for Friday's Daily Bible Study coming from Charlene's Outreach Ministry. We have a wonderful and powerful lesson today, Sarah's Faith. We are talking about Sarah's faith coming from Hebrews 11, verses 11 through 13. Amen. We are looking at the children of faith in the scriptures this week. Amen. Praise the Lord. As we speak about Jesus' resurrection, we're looking at the children of the Old Testament, their faith. Amen. That give them the entitlement to be, as they said, awaiting their Savior that was to come, which was Jesus Christ. Amen. We have a great and powerful lesson, but before we get started, I want to ask if anything is said, touch your heart, soul, or spirit. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to jot them at the bottom of the screen below, and I will get to them as soon as possible. Also, if you will, subscribe to my channel and join with us as we gather together to study and meditate on the Word of the Lord. Amen. We're going to get ready and get started, but first we're going to have prayer, then we're going to move right into the lesson. Amen. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is done in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into no temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of thine. Dear God in heaven, we thank you, Father. We thank you for all the many blessings that you bestow upon us. We thank you for making a way out of no way. We thank you for leading and guiding us in your true path of righteousness, Father. We thank you, Father, for giving us a mind to study and meditate on your word, Father. We thank you, Father, for all that you have done, you is doing, and you shall do in each of our life. Lord, we thank you, Heavenly Father, and that you open our understanding as we study and meditate on your word in Jesus' name. Lord, we ask that our eyes be open that we see and our ears open that we hear, and we gain wisdom, knowledge, and understanding from on high as we study and meditate on your word, Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Our lesson, as we stated, Sarah's faith. Sarah's faith. Amen. And our lesson is coming from Hebrews 11, verses 11 through 13. And the scripture lesson text read, through faith also, Sarah herself received strength to conceive seed and was delivered of a child when she was past age, because she judged him faithful who had promised. Therefore sprang there even of one, and him as good as dead, so many as the stars of the sky in multitude, and as the sand which is by the seashore, innumerable. These all died in faith, not having received the promise, but having seen them afar off, and were persuaded of them, and embraced them, and confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims on the earth. By faith, Sarah was miraculously empowered to receive when she was about 90 years old. Amen. As we look at this hymn, we see that Sarah was up in age when she conceived. She was at 90 some years old, and there isn't known of anybody that's conceived at that age, but she did. It says when she could but she knew that God had promised her a baby, and she knew he could not go back on his word. She had shatterproof faith that he would do what he had said he would do, what he had promised. Abraham was about 99 when Isaac was born. Humanly speaking, it was just about impossible for him to become a father. Yet God had promised a numerous posterity, and so it must be. Through Isaac Abraham became the father of an innumerable earthly family, the Hebrew nation. Through Christ, he became father of an innumerable spiritual family. That is, true believers of every subsequent age. The sand by the seashore is pictured the earthly prodigy which the stars of the sky illustrate. The heavenly people, the patriarchs, all died in faith. They died not living to see the fulfillment of the divine promise. For instance, Abraham never saw his numerous prodigy. The Hebrew nation never occupied all the land that had been promised to it. The Old Testament saints never saw the fulfillment of the promise of the Messiah, but their telescopic vision brought the promises near, so near that they are pictured as waving at them in joyful anticipation. They realized that this world was not their final home. They were content to be strangers and pilgrims, refusing the urge to nestle to make themselves comfortable. Their desire was to pass through the world without taking any of its character upon themselves. Their hearts were set on pilgrimage. Psalms 84 and 5. Amen. It's a powerful statement, as their hearts were set on what was to come. Without ever seeing it, they believed it to be so. And it came so, even though it didn't come in their time. Amen. We have to have that same faith. We receive Christ. We have him. Now we have to know that our home that is to come shall be there. As Jesus said, in his word, that he was going to prepare a place for us. Amen. And he has prepared that place. We just have to be ready to go when our time comes. Amen. This is a great and powerful lesson. I pray you meditate on this lesson and have a wonderful and blessed day. God bless you.